Welcome to today's episode, which is sponsored by Vasion Print, formerly known as Printer Logic. Vasion lets you simplify your IT infrastructure by replacing those resource-intensive print servers with direct IP serverless printing. With its built-in AI and automations, Vasion Print is a cloud-native solution that helps eliminate one of the biggest drains on your IT resources. See more at Vasion.com.
We are here at IDC's 60th annual Directions Conference here in San Jose, California. And I'm delighted to say I'm joined today by Ryan Reith, who is the Group Vice President for Worldwide Device Trackers for IDC. And I'd love to hear, Ryan, your thoughts in a sentence or two about the state of play, the general state of play with AI and the IT buyers that you were talking to. What's top of mind for them?
Sure. Well, thanks for having me here today. So my focus is really on devices. So sort of the end user client. And right now, when it comes to AI and IT, it's really the educational phase. You know, so IT knows that, you know, we're sort of starting with AI in the cloud. It's there's a lot of discussion about moving this on premise for multiple reasons, security increases, latency and cost. And then there's that last mile of bringing it down to AI that can run on the hardware itself. So, you know, really, I think IT is trying to grapple with, when is the right time to invest? These machines cost more than the average PC, obviously. Right. And when's the right time to invest where there's a guaranteed ROI? And I think right now, IT is struggling a little bit with all of the other AI tasks I have and really waiting for that ROI to be defined. And it'll get there, but we're, I would say, in the preseason, not even the first season.
Yeah, definitely something we hear on the CIO side talking to IT buyers, that finding that return on investment is a really tricky thing. And I suppose maybe efficiency is one thing that people are trying to drive with AI. Okay, so using AI to drive efficiency within organizations potentially could have a major impact on the workplace of the future.
Yeah.
What can organizations and employees look forward to? What is the impact on end user devices, say phones and laptops?
Yeah, absolutely. So, I mean, the short answer is they should expect their current tasks and day-to-day to fundamentally change. Now, when that actually happens, time will tell. But the roles and responsibilities that we know today will fundamentally change. That is a fact. It's going to be all aspects of AI. And really, it should be embraced in a way to be a more productive, more efficient company. You know, with change comes, you know, uncertainty and uncomfortableness, and that's to be expected. Mm-hmm. But it's really going to improve the efficiency of the employees who are working on products or services for a company. And even within the organization, you know, IT should expect their own tools and their own processes to increase in terms of the productivity and completely change the way they handle things. Again, change will create uncomfortableness, but it will bring more benefit and more efficiency in the long run as we get to this.
So like 1,000 tiny little efficiencies for each individual wrapping up to like a major impact on the internal.
Yeah, and I think in the reality is some roles and responsibilities will no longer be needed, but they're going to evolve to other things. So, you know, people shouldn't be too hung up on this. You know, people won't be needed because they will. It's just going to be what they're needed for is going to continue to pivot in a much more productive and opportunistic future, in my opinion.
Okay, so that's thinking about the inside of an organization, right? Now, one thing we talk about sometimes is AI outside. So, you know, AI infused into products and services that an organization has. And we're hearing a lot of noise about AI PCs and other hardware devices. So from what you're saying, you know, you think there's definitely a future in that, but should IT buyers be all in on the AI PC? You know, can we think of any killer use cases at this point, or are we still in that wait and see phase?
Yeah, it's definitely the wait and see. There is no one that, there's no company that if you don't invest in a true AI PC this year, 2025, that you'll be left behind. Mm-hmm. You should be working on the strategy. You should have an understanding of what the benefits will be when those use cases come, because as you mentioned, they're just not there today. But there's a lot of investment that's happening from silicon players like Intel is working with, they've publicly said over 100 ISVs on AI solutions that can be brought and utilized on the AI PC. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of work that's being done, but we're not quite there yet. Kind of wait and see.
I have to say, I think that's advice that our sort of viewers would really like to hear, honestly. Yeah. Like that you've got to be planning for it, but don't panic if you're not there right now, kind of thing.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's understanding that some people would panic, right? You've got all this buzz. You want to do everything right. This is that last mile when it comes to within the corporation, whether it's used for inside, outside, or both.
Okay. And thinking about kind of a specific slice of that, which is the idea of the workplace of the future. Again, that is the future, right? But, you know, setting up the human workforce for success in an AI-driven world, like what kind of things should IT decision makers be thinking about at this point?
Well, it's really what are the critical tools and needs of the company, but realistically, you know, breaking it down to the individual divisions, but even within the division, there's going to be bifurcation of the need for these more sophisticated PCs and then more mainstream, you know, which is more sophisticated, essentially being Gen AI PCs. In the past, we used to see that more like departments, you know, like graphics design would have specific PCs, the rest of the organization. And now it's actually going to be within divisions. You're going to see that in the early stages because there's only going to be a need for maybe 10%, that's hypothetical, 10% of this team on product, you know, development would need this, or software design, maybe the lead 10% would use this to accelerate tools that they're building. Uh-huh. And eventually that's going to be 100%.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of when, a couple of years.
Yeah. Okay. That makes total sense because then what you're doing there is you're applying a workforce strategy and then the application of technology to it.
Absolutely.
Rather than the kits can do this, so we're going to do that kind of thing.
Absolutely. And by the way, on the outside, there's a million examples of things that have developers and stuff just licking their chops. I mean, there's independent developers that used to need, you know, a big team.
Right.
They can now leverage code that's been written and open sourced and so forth to do incredible things. Things are going to move very quickly. So game developers are looking at this and utilizing this quickly. Pretty all software developers, people trying to implement changes to their business processes on the outside, you know, think field service workers, they're looking to automate this even more so with AI.
Okay. And there's an implication for at the device level for all of these.
Absolutely.
Things. Okay.
Absolutely.
So if like there's a huge amount to think about there and I feel like we could talk for hours, but we haven't got hours. So if you could sort of boil it down to kind of what's one piece of advice you would give for the IT buyers that you work with, around like AI and the future, what should they be thinking about and doing right now in 2025?
Yeah, in 2025 right now, when it comes to hardware and devices, prepare yourself, understand what's out there today, why it's not in probably as high demand as the supply side of the industry would want, and then try to follow along with these timelines of what's going to be coming. So really the key is less on who's making the product, the Lenovo's, the Dell's. It's more on the silicon side right now. What is Intel doing? What is AMD doing? Yep. What is Nvidia doing and Qualcomm? That's really what they should be following because the next generation of what those launch into PCs is most likely what many are going to adopt in 2026 for their AI PC strategy in their corporation. That's what IT should be focusing on today to get knowledge for tomorrow.
Excellent. That's great advice, Ryan. Really appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Great. Thank you.